This is Lenny Farley, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to give you some ID characteristics for a species that is not native to Indiana, but is found here as an escape from past plantings and also as an invasive in some cases. And that is Osage Orange, also sometimes called hedgeapple. Osage Orange was originally from parts of Arkansas and other areas like the Ozarks, but it's been planted here extensively in the past for fence rows and fence post plantings because it has very decay resistant wood. Osage Orange has alternate leaf arrangement, simple leaves with entire, or what you would consider smooth margins, no lobes, no teeth. The leaves are somewhat similar to what we might see on persimmon or black gum. One of the great characteristics for identification of Osage Orange is on older twigs, we'll oftentimes find very stout, sharp thorns. These thorns will be a half to 5/8 inch long and located on the areas where the leaves emerge and where the buds are. And this is typically on year-old or older twigs. Osage Orange can get to be a large tree, but tend to be more spreading and lower in height than many of our native species, more almost like an orchard tree. And you can see that the bark has somewhat of an orange undercolor, but the surface is a light gray. This can look a little bit like sassafras, but sassafras bark tends to be a little darker, stronger oranges, and of course is aromatic. So it can get to be a large tree, but has a tendency to want to spread out, be multi-stemmed. One of the great characteristics for identification of Osage Orange is the fruit that it produces. And so, as the name indicates, the fruit can look somewhat like a large orange, or as hedgeapple would say, a green lumpy apple. Some people have compared it to looking like a green brain in some cases, with those little undulations and folds, much like a brain has. These fruits can be relatively large and have a milky sap on the inside that's very sticky. So as we mentioned, a species that's not native here in Indiana, but was widely planted many years ago for fence rows, and we still find it living on the landscape and sometimes escaping from cultivation, and that's Osage Orange.